There should be a variety of things, but one of the ones, and we should never ignore this, is teacher observation. It's one of the reasons why when we look at Hattie's work and now Fisher, Hattie, and Fry's work, that the small group has such a powerful impact. And we want to be careful not just put low ability kids, ability grouping isn't as strong, but small group instruction is strong. And one of the reasons small group instruction has a strong impact, the potential for it, is that I can sit and watch these students, how they were responding. You got it, you got it, you didn't, you two are doing well, why don't you work together and I can work on this. So teacher observation, but that's nearly impossible to do in a whole class. So we have to have small group instruction so that we can watch, I can ask a little question, I can ask again, I can do that on the in the moment kind of assessment. Then we do have other tools. The benchmark screening that we've learned to do 3 times a year, if we're doing that correctly and understand how to interpret that, that's a good thing, especially at early elementary. Quick little diagnostic tools that teachers can, do you know, how strong is your phonemic awareness or not? Quick little informal tools. We don't need to call in a school psychologist or a reading specialist. Make sure teachers have those tools and know how to use them.